I remember lying on the narrow bed of my college dorm, eyes fixed on the slow, the hypnotical spin of the ceiling fan above me. It was the first year. I hadn't written a single line of working code. I didn't have the clear direction, and no one around me had any reason to believe I was building towards something meaningful. And that question kept repeating in my head, boss. What if I go home with nothing? What if I fail publicly and completely? That fear didn't visit occasionally. It moved in. I wasn't just about a performance. It was about identity. I didn't want to just pass. I didn't want a certificate or a safe job. I wanted to build something that gave me a reason to stay. Around the time, I came across a line from Sundar Pichai. More than a quarter of all new code at Google is now generated by AI. And then a few days later, I read these lines from the Dario Amodai of Anthropic. AI could replace up to the 50% of the entry-level white-collar jobs in the next 5 years. And the another headline was, Microsoft lays off 3% of its workforce as it's pivot for AI. I wasn't looking for the stories, but they kept showing. They didn't scare me, they clarified the things. If AI could write a code at Google, what did that mean for someone like me? Still figuring out a syntax, let alone a systems. What I want to talk today is not a success story. It's a chain of decisions. Most of them born from the discomfort that led to something I didn't expect. When I started at college, I had no roadmap, no four-year plan. Just this vague and the persistent need to create something that mattered. My first year is passed with a kind of numbness. Even I tried coding often out of road under the confusion, more than the curiosity. Sometimes it clicked, most times it didn't. And then the ChatGPT is launched. I didn't feel buried under the syntax errors and the endless searches. Things that took hours, now it took a minute. The friction is dropped and the resistance is lowered. It didn't make me feel smarter, it made me feel capable. In my second year, I entered a national level hackathon. There I competing against the IIT students with way more training and the exposure. That was the first time I built my real world application. We didn't win the finals, but we came second. And for the first time, I felt, I'm not here by accident, I can do this. But my third year, that's when it hit me hardest. I had ideas, big ones, no one to build them with. No team, no resource, no community. And then came the darkest thoughts of all. What if I fail? They didn't just knock on my door. It lived inside my chest for every second and every breath. That was a specific kind of silence that follows you when you are trying to building alone. It's not a quiet, it's a pressure. You were constantly second-guessing whether I was wasting a time, falling behind, or hallucinating a progress. In the middle of the silence, I watched a video about 18 years old who built an AI startup from the scratch that turned into a multi-million dollar company. No degree, no team, just the execution. I sat up straight and asked myself, why not me? From that point on, my approach changed. I didn't try harder, I built differently. I am here today because of the tools that changed my life, the intelligent and the agentic systems. I want to prove that innovation isn't reserved for elite, it's possible for anyone. I stopped waiting for the co-founders and the mentors. I started designing the systems using the AI agents. When I need a co-founder, I built one, an agent to challenge the assumptions, propose features and critique strategy. When I need a technical guidance, I built a virtual CTO, an agent to evaluate the stacks, spot the vulnerabilities, and adapt with the feedback. It was clunky at first, but the shift was real. I wasn't outsourcing the creativity. I was building the working environment, not with the people, but with a protocol-based intelligence. And something started to happen. Ideas became a drafts became a prototype, and the prototype became a product. And for the first time, I wasn't thinking about getting a job. I was thinking about building a system. I wasn't building alone anymore. I had a boardroom of agents, meeting, planning, designing, all inside a single laptop. And it started with the question, Can I turn this idea into something real? And the agent said, let's build it. I have cried alone at 2 a.m. wondering if it's all worth it. I watched my friends relax while I wrestled with the fear, failure and the purpose. There were days I wanted to give up. There were nights I questioned my value. But when I saw my first AI-generated roadmap, my first working prototype, it didn't feel like a student anymore. I felt like a creator. Agentic systems didn't give me a confidence. They gave me a bandwidth, enough mental space to think clearly, test quickly, and recover from the failure without spiraling. And I realized this. The future isn't something about you enter, it's something you configure. And right now, the configuration layer is more accessible than it's ever been. Conversation around the innovation still leans on the prestige, degrees, network, capital, and the founder letters. But the tool themselves, they don't care where you're from. They respond to the input. So the question is, can you build something impressive? No. The real question is, can you describe your problem clearly enough for a system help you to build a response? That's not a motivational idea. It's a technical one. Agentic AI won't hand you success. It won't validate your dreams, but it will reduce the friction between the thoughts and the execution. And in the world of overthinking, that is a structural advantage. So no, I don't think myself is a visionary, and this talk isn't an invitation to dream bigger. In a case study, using what existing to build, what's missing, especially when no one is giving you permission to try, because sometimes the only way to earn a space is to take it quietly, carefully, and systematically. Thank you, everyone.